Azure Elastic Jobs Manager enables seamless management of Elastic jobs in Azure directly from your desktop. This tool serves as an extension to Visual Studio 2017, 19, 22, SQL Server Management Studio 18, 19, and can also work as a standalone tool. In this demo, we will see how to create a target group in Azure Elastic Job to execute the T-SQL script using Azure Elastic Jobs Manager. Before creating your first job with Azure Elastic Jobs Manager, ensure the Azure Elastic Job Service is created. Enable a user-assigned managed identity on the Elastic Job Service. Grant permission to the user-assigned managed identity across all target databases to execute the T-SQL code. Launch Azure Elastic Jobs Manager extension. Begin, click Next. Enter the Elastic Jobs Agent database credentials with SQL Server authentication. Use the least privileged credentials to create and manage the jobs in the Elastic Jobs Agent. Choose connection options. If you have enabled user-assigned managed identity, keep this checkbox checked and click Next to connect. On a successful connection, the landing screen would appear. Click on the New Target Group button to create the first target group and provide a name. Click the Create button. To add in SQL database target, click on the Add Target button. Select Include Membership Type and SQL Database as a target type. Provide the name of the Azure SQL Server containing the target database, followed by the database name. Click OK to add target. You can add as many targets as you want. The target summary will show the newly added target, with an option to delete it. Our first target group is ready. Let us create a new job to execute the T-SQL script on this target group. Provide a unique name to the job. To manage job steps, click on the Steps page. To add a step, click New button. Provide a name for this step. Notice that credentials are optional because we have enabled user-assigned managed identity for this Elastic Agent job. Pick the target group and enter the T-SQL script that you need to execute on the target group. Let us skip the advanced settings and output settings. Click OK to save the job step. Add as many steps as you want. To manage schedule, click on the Schedule page. The job can be scheduled to run only once or at a frequency between specified start and end dates. By default, the date times are in your local time zone. You can change the time zone in the settings section of this tool. Let us run this job only once. Click on the Script button to view the job definition in T-SQL. Click OK to create the job. Great! Our first job is ready. Upon refresh, you can see that the job has been executed automatically. Click on the View History menu item of the job to know the status of the job execution. We can see that the job status is successful. Let us connect to the target database, and we can see that the job has created the employee table in the target database. Let us connect to the Azure portal. We can see the job definition we just created using Azure Elastic Jobs Manager. Azure Elastic Jobs Manager supports a lot more features and customizations. To know more, check out the documentation link in the description section. Thank you for watching.